Welcome to this BEC podcast. My name is Rasmus Bæk, and today with me, two sisters who has been part of the European top for quite some time now, and of course, Gabriella and Stephanie Støjberg. Welcome to you guys.
Thank you.
It's been a while. I've seen you the last time. We have had a very, very long break because of COVID, but now back to action. Gabriella, how's the form?
I think pretty well. We have a few months of because of COVID, we take a break. So we try at home to keep the shape, but it's quite hard when you're not allowed to go out and to do your stuff. So we try to give our best. And I think our shape getting back slowly, but I think now we're in good shape.
Stephanie, we know that you are living in France normally, but I don't think you've been in France very much. Have you during COVID? It's been also Bulgaria, I assume.
Yeah, we spent 11 months at home, which never happened since we moved to France. I think it was like a positive thing. We could rest like mentally. We could be with our family. We could charge our battery with positive thoughts and energy. And I think it was, on the one side, it's a good thing because of the traveling, a lot of tournaments all the time. And I think it was quite good, but also we missed our practices with our coaches. And I think it was okay and not okay, but we try to keep the shape at our place. And I think it was working out.
What do you miss the most about France when you were in Bulgaria for 11 months, Gabriela?
Maybe the practice. Also our coach. We've been separate. Actually, we never be separate when we was in France with him, like on practice, on tournament. And when we go back to Bulgaria, suddenly we separate. Also the team. We miss also the team events, our matches with the team. This was, it's different from the tournament. Yeah, this was missing us, but I think when we was in Bulgaria, we tried to keep up with another things that we couldn't make it with the badminton. So I think this was have minus and plus in this situation.
What did you catch up with in Bulgaria, Stephanie, with the things you normally don't do?
I could spend time with my dog.
She could take her driving lessons finally after so many years.
Yes.
We start university finally after so many years waiting. So we have positive things, also spend time with our family, the dog. I think he misses most than our parents, but yeah, we try to keep up. Of course, we miss the badminton, but also sometimes we need to take a little bit break for all these kind of things, travel, badminton, just to, like Sissi said, to recharge the battery and that we can back stronger.
How is it to now go to your university then?
It's strange.
It's very strange, different life.
Yes, but it's interesting to see something else, to study something else, and it's, I think, quite good for us. It's not only badminton, so it's okay.
This is recorded in the end of April 2021 in Kyiv during the European Championships. We don't know who is going to win on Sunday. Here, you are the top seed though, so everybody's looking at you, but that's another story. But most of the badminton fans in Europe sees you as Europe number one. You are the number one in ranking. You won the last time we had a European Championships. But do you feel like the spot is more safe now? Or is it less safe than it was like 1-2 years ago?
I think everybody improved in Europe. The European pairs, we can see on tournaments that everybody is improving. We are in the ranking first, but I think everybody can go ahead of us. Depends on the results on the tournaments. If we give like 100%, we can keep the spot, but if other pairs are giving their best, they can go ahead. But I think we don't look like we are first in Europe and we are the best in Europe. We just see for ourselves, giving our best on court, trying to give good performance on tournament, and just want good results.
When we had the Danish pair, Camilla Rødder-Juel and Christina Pedersen, they were dominating. There was no doubt that they were the better pair also when they played against you guys. We could see, just go see the result and everybody will know that's right. But it seems like there is a gap now. Is that because Europe is in general become stronger, as you said, Stefan? Or is it actually become because Europe is weaker compared to the Asians? Do you know what I mean?
Yeah, but I don't think so that Europe now it's not like good for against Asian, because we can see in the couple of the tournaments that some of the doubles from Europe make big results against the top seeded of Asia. And I think this is very good for us, like a double who is coming from Europe, that we can compare it against the Asians, even some doubles like the Danish, the English, the Holland pairs, all they can combine, now they can win against the Asian, and this is very good for Europe, like the badminton, because we know that Asia is the dominate in this.
I think it's changed also. Yeah. During the time when Camille and Christina were the best Europe double, there were no other European double. I think Selena was playing doubles.
Would you fair?
Yes, they were the second double who could compare to the Asians. But I think now change in the Europe is improving a lot in the women's double.
We spoke earlier this week before the championships. I'm not going to use the words you used, because you said that women's double might be the less interesting to watch.
Not too interesting. It's like a little bit boring.
That was what you said. That's not what I say.
Boring.
But from what you explained, I understand what you mean. Yeah. But. What is it that women's doubles need to change to be more attractive, in your opinion? And if you find it a bit boring to watch, what is it that your category needs to improve?
I don't find it watching for boring. Actually, I like this kind of matches, which is going more than one hour and a half, even two. For me, it's very interesting to see that some badminton matches, especially in the ladies double, going like 2 hours, like in the tennis, because you cannot see, it's like even more different. But I think that I said like it's boring because it's too many rallies. You don't know what will happen, and it continue only this. And I think for some of the spectators, when they watch, they found it boring, because if you watch it from outside, for you it's like only clear drop slowing game, but in the court is not like this. In the court is not even, it's not boring at all.
Maybe in women's double we need to become like more aggressive, like the Koreans are doing, the Chinese pair and some of the Japanese pair, but not everybody likes to be like aggressive. They like to play defense, to be patient on court, but it depends on the player. Yeah. Which style they prefer and in which style they are feeling like more relaxed, and which is the best for them.
There is a proposal to change the scoring system for badminton. What is your opinion on that one?
We have played also this scoring system.
Yes.
Until 11 points.
I think the year before the Olympics.
Yes.
In Brazil.
The match was going so fast when we play best of five until 11 points.
Yeah.
I prefer 21.
Yeah, I also prefer 21. It's
we are used to this game. You can change the tactic on 11 points, and if you play until 11 points, it's going so fast, and you need to be focused from the first game.
But you just have another game then.
It's
just that, okay, then you just play the second game, the third game.
Yeah, but you can like wake up in the third set.
Yeah, sometimes. Especially for us, if we're not focused
from the beginning,
we're just losing like several points. Like maybe we will be 10-5, and then we need to try to keep up. Sometimes we.
But it's going very fast.
Yeah, and if it's like until 11.
I played also single until 11 points.
Yeah,
I can remember. Yeah, but I prefer 21 points.
Are you going to stop playing badminton if they change the scoring system?
No.
Okay, good.
We have put some targets,
yeah,
but now we focus on the Olympics.
Yes.
In Tokyo.
Do you guys remember when they went from 15 to 21? Do you remember that? Because it's You have been very young back then, but do you remember it?
No, actually, yeah, we played. Even I remember they have one different rule when one of us can serve and make mistake, then you can change.
Then you get the second serve.
Yeah, you have the second serve. I remember this, but we was very, very young, like.
Because there was also complaints back then regarding the 21, but now it seems like a lot of people also say, okay, 21 is fine. Do you think that people will just adjust to new scoring system, or will we see players retiring saying, okay, I don't want to play anymore?
I think it's like everything new which somebody give. In the first you said, oh, this is something different.
We are not used to time to adjust to
this. You're not used, and maybe if we try and if they put it like the new scoring system, we cannot do anything.
You can't just retire just because of the scoring system.
You need to get used on this, and suddenly you start playing on this new scoring system.
Part of the game.
Yeah, it's part of the game. You just get used.
Stephanie, you said it. We have some targets. First Olympics. We're not still sure when this is going to be published, so maybe you already played the Olympics, you never know. But there's also another target in Europe in 2021. You're going back to Huelva, where you won your very first European gold medal. I assume that the World Championships in November will be quite a big task for you, am I right?
Yes.
What do you believe you can do in Huelva this time?
I think three times we were stopped at last 16 rounds. For sure we want to be in quarterfinal, why not in the medals? But for us, we put a target this time to pass last 16 rounds.
Yeah, we always put target now the European Championship, then Olympics, and then the World Championship. We always put targets because if we don't...
To keep the motivation.
Yeah, to keep the motivation and try to give our best.
Maybe let's try to speak out those targets. What's the target for the European Championship?
For us to win it, of course.
Yeah, to win it, of course.
Because we didn't play the European Games in Belarus.
2019?
Yes, in 2019. So for us, title will be great. Just watching match by match.
And Olympics, what's the target?
Olympics?
For now, the target is to get seeded for the Olympics because it's quite close with the Taipei. So we will try to be seeded, and it will be great if we get in the first eight. And for sure, quarterfinal or medal.
And quarterfinal and quarterfinals also for Huelva, for the World Championships, that's the big goal.
If we go to the medal, we'll be even more highest than...
Yes, we want to pass this last 16 rounds.
Yes.
How do you look at the Super 1000, Super 750, Super 500 tournaments? It's been a while since we have seen you play in these kind of tournaments, and you have been so close to actually also making the very, very big result on the World Tour. How far are you from that, you think?
I think not so far, just... For us, when we go on the court, the mental, we need to be more focused to try our best, not because sometimes we're losing the focus.
Patient.
Yeah, we're not patient. We need to work on this. But I think when we get closer and closer, we will make the biggest results. Just need to be more patient.
But of course, we need to be... on this final stage at the Super Series events, like we did in French Open and also All England, we play our first quarter final. So we miss this feeling.
One question that always pops up in my head when I see you two play is that, of course, you guys are still young. There's a lot for you to come, but someday it will stop. Someday you guys will not walk on court anymore, and you are doing everything together. You have told me that before. You told me that, I think, 5 years ago. What do you do one day, Gabriel, if Stephanie comes and says, it's enough, I'm going to retire, or the other way around? Have you ever thought about that?
Yeah, we actually, when the COVID came, we started to think about, we talk actually a lot of this. For us, the final stop of our career, we talk it from long time, it's the Olympics in Paris, because it's in France. And I think we will be on the, this age, which it's the best for us to retire it, of course. We talk, but if she want before this, if she said to me, I want to stop, it's enough for me, these kind of things, for me it will be okay, because we are always together, we talk about this, we never keep it in secret, or we don't say this. If she said, I will say, okay, it's no problem for me, because we are double. So I need to respect her decision. And yeah, I think she will be do the same for me.
Do you agree, Stephanie?
Yeah, I agree, because we are double, and we did sports since very early age. I think since 7 years we are together. So of course I will respect her decision if she say it's enough. But at the moment we said it will be
I think the hardest thing is not that if she said to me I will stop, or me I will say to her I will stop. The hardest thing is when we stop and we need to separate. I think this will be the hardest one. Because we used to do everything
together.
We're living together, we do practically everything together, and suddenly when we stop we need to separate, and then
why?
Because I think we have a different
views
of the life. I think this will be, even sometimes when we're in Bulgaria to take a little break, and when I go somewhere or she goes somewhere, we are always on the phone and texting. We cannot separate.
But what you tell me now is that you will retire after the Paris Olympic.
Maybe, yeah. I think on this.
But what if you win?
This will be perfect.
This will be perfect.
Then we can stay for the World Championship in France. Because in 2025 it will be in France. So
yeah.
Our coach wants us to be at the Olympics and also the World Championship. So
we talk because in like double we are responsible to each other. But when we see that we start the badminton in so very young age, we do so many competition, we have so good results, we want even more from Olympics world. But in one point we start thinking, we just need to say that Olympics in Paris will be our final destination, and to make sure that we achieve everything back then, that we can win the medal of Olympics, if it's possible now in Tokyo, then the World Championships, European, it's continued, so yeah.
But it's very far.
Yeah, it's very far.
We don't want to talk about retirement, we just need to be focused on the...
But it's only 3 years.
Yes,
yeah.
If you see...
But these 3 years have so many World Championship, European, different tournaments, so we'll try to achieve every goal which we put until then.
And I assume you also have a European Games medal more you want to win in Krakow, because you got the first one.
Yes.
And especially Stephanie, I understood for you that you really wanted one more. You didn't get it in Minsk, but you get one more shot in Krakow then.
Yes, well, I wanted to make it 3 out of 3, but we couldn't in 2019. So for sure, 2023,
which we want to achieve until the next one comes.
Ladies, thank you very much for stopping by, and I now have on paper that Paris 2024 is the final destination. Let's see if that changes. It might change
One
or two times
before 2023, but thank you very much for coming. Thank you very much for watching the podcast. Remember to go and follow the ladies on social media. They're actually doing a quite good job, and I'm pretty sure you will also find a picture of this podcast recording on their social media platforms. Remember, you can also follow Badminton Europe. Thank you very much for watching.